In this video I will show you how to make the coat. For this tutorial I use off-white and blue fabric. The off-white fabric has a rough texture, while the blue fabric has a fine texture, and it's a bit thinner too. First lay down the off-white fabric, and then I use some paper templates that I made to draw copies of the coat, sleeves and hood patterns onto the fabric. Then lay down the blue fabric and make copies of the custom parts that needs to be blue. After you cut out all the patterns, you can lay the white coat shape onto the blue coat shape with the loose ends and sew together at the top and bottom. After the coat layers are sewn together, you can grab the blue curve shape and sew it onto the coat. Make sure the rough edges are folded over and hidden underneath. You should use a brown thread for this job, so there is a brown edge visible later on. And since you are sewing with the brown thread anyway, you can sew the decorative brown lines on the coat too. Next you can fold over the blue edge and loose ends and make buttonholes in them. And also note that the blue ends make a twist about halfway down. After that has been done, you can sew the top together. First fold over the point pieces so they are partly overlapping the front of the coat. Make sure the blue edge is not underneath the points. They will overlap the points later on. After the top has been sewn together, it's time for some buttons. For the blue edge I have some dark brown buttons. And for the loose ends I have some shiny silver buttons. After the buttons are sewn to the coat, you can lay to the side for a while and move over to your sleeve patterns. First measure out where your elbows will be, and then sew the half circle shapes to the sleeves using brown thread. And you can also add the decorative brown line and sew the sleeves together so the sew lines are running on top of your arm. Next it's time for some more buttons. Those will be attached to the half circle pieces you sewn to the arm pieces, and they are purely decorative as they don't hold anything together. And finally you can attach the sleeves to the coat. Lay the coat to the side again and move over to your collar patterns. First fold the off-white rectangle in half. This will give the collar some stiffness. And then get the blue rectangle and lay it on top of the white one and sew them together. Then I use two small buttons and sew them to each end of the collar. Now move over to your hood pieces and start with the off-white centerpiece. I use the button setting of my sewing machine to sew the image of an eagle onto the piece. Then I sewn all the off-white and blue pieces together so I have a blue and an off-white hood. Then I merge them together so the outside is off-white and the inside is blue, and sew them together along the edge. Next get your coat again and sew the collar and hood on top of it. You might want to put on the coat and ask someone else to help determine the location where you want to sew your hood on. Next I made two strips using off-white and blue fabric and made a buttonhole in each end. Then I attached two buttons on the left and right shoulder on the coat and attached the strips. As final touch I will make the flaps that are on the side of the coat. So get the flaps pieces and sew them together using blue thread. And then I use the button setting again to make the three stripes on each flap. Then I sew the flaps to the coat. And you can actually make them functional by making a cut underneath and sew a pocket behind. Alright, the flaps were the last pieces that had to be done, and that means the coat is finished. This was my coat tutorial. Thanks for watching.